Now, ever since my The Insane Power of Lightning McQueen video, I'd say that that video did pretty well. But this got me to question, how powerful are other characters within the Pixar's Cars universe? And well, that's where I'm going to be answering today. Lightning McQueen's best friend, Sir Tomator. Yeah, that's who it was called by the end of Cars 2 by the Queen of England. But anyways, Sir Tomator is a truck. A tow truck. The common tow truck. The tow truck that you wouldn't actually expect to be a very powerful entity or a very powerful challenge to take on. But however, just like how I explained with Lightning McQueen, you can't judge a book by its cover. And with Tomator, this is an absolute case. So, like Lightning McQueen, we're going to be going through all of Mater's appearances since we want him at his absolute best and at his absolute full power. Which means we're going through the movies, the Mater's Tall Tales, and the video games. So, without further ado, it's time for the Sir Tomator Power Scale. Now, of course, just like Lightning McQueen, the first section we're going to be talking about is Tomator's speed. Now, as for his speed, many of the things that Mater can does, he can easily scale off of Lightning McQueen. So, just like Lightning McQueen per se, he could reach the speed of 198 miles per hour, but then again, he is a tow truck after all, not exactly a race car, so yeah. But the real answer to his speed is that if we give him his boosters. At the end of Cars 2, when Finn and Holly are leaving on their next mission, Mater asks them if he could have one more thing. And that thing was his rocket boosters. Yep, that's right. His rocket boosters allow him to travel at even faster speeds, possibly even faster than Lightning McQueen himself. And yeah, as you saw during the end of the movie, with Mater's jet boosters, he was able to keep up and even pass the rest of the World Grand Prix racers. And let me remind you, these World Grand Prix racers are highly experienced in their craft. They have been racing for a very long time, and they've been highly trained. And for Mater to pass all of them with his jet boosters, it was pretty obvious he would keep up. But hey, he at least actually managed to keep up, and that's no laughing matter. A racer's craft is always a no laughing matter. So for Mater to actually do that, it's very impressive. Then another part in Cars 2 where Mater's being chased by Lightning. Yeah, Lightning is pretty much still going fast, but Mater is still going faster than him while going backwards. Yeah, that's pretty impressive too. But this is the final part of the section of speed. What if I told you that Sir Tomator has traveled through time before? Well, in the Cars 2 short Time Travel Mater, Mater accidentally makes the sign fall on him, and while the clock was on there, the clock fell on his motor. Yeah. Then he sneezed and went backwards so fast that he traveled through time and back to the past when Radiator Springs wasn't discovered yet. Yeah, Mater was so fast just simply going backwards while the clock was on him, he managed to go back in time and meet Stanley. Yeah, I would probably say that with that alone, Mater is faster than Lightning McQueen himself. And even Jackson Storm. Jackson Storm may be the fastest Pistons Cup racer, but that doesn't mean he's overall the fastest car of the franchise, which, I don't know, that could possibly go to Mater. Now it's time we talk about Mater's attack potency. And we're going to be using the Mate example as in Cars 2 the video game. Mater in Cars 2 the video game acts like a lot of the other characters in that game, since they are basically scaled down to have the equal same amount of power, but even then, Mater in his video games also has an extreme amount of power too, as shown, he has the ability to jump, drift, boost, and do multiple different stunts. He also has access to different weapons like the missiles, the rapid fires, and even the mines and the bombs. He also has the ability to go into the zone, which allows him to go extremely fast for a short while. I would say that Mater's speed during this time should be at the very least supersonic, as he is capable of passing all the other cars around him and can make them fly off the track easily. And he also has the durability to survive many of the different attacks from other cars within the game, like multiple different missiles and the rapid fires and the bombs, and yeah. He also has the ability to use energy manipulation, as he can use the power, like this weapon for example, to pretty much stop boost from other cars, and even steal boost from other cars. He could also prove to do that in Cars 3, the video game, as well. And here's another smaller example of his attack potency level in Cars 1, where Lightning is driving backwards to pass around Chick. Mater then again tells the other pities of Chick's crew that he taught him that, and he uses Lightning's same ka-chow, pretty much catchphrase, and instead uses it as his mirror and use it from Light. So this proves that as long as Light is around, that being the sun, Mater can use his rearview mirrors to flash and really blind his opponents and really distract them, so therefore he can use that to his advantage. And the last example of attack potency is in, once again, Cars 2, where Mater is seen literally punching Ivan in the face and him flying backwards. And another example is him punching this lemon, kicking him essentially with his rear tire, and pretty much just killing them all, not killing them, but just at the very least possibly knocking them out. Mater obviously has the strength to do that since he is a literal tow truck, and could use his tow cable to pretty much whip any other car he wants to just make them fly off in the air. So yeah, that's another perfect example of Mater's attack potency in the final part of the attack potency section. So now, we're going to be moving on. Next up, we have strength. Now, strength is something that tow trucks can naturally have. They could pick up cars and, yeah, tow them to the next repair shop or something. But as for Mater, he's a special case. He's not some ordinary tow truck. As seen in Mater's tall tale short, Monster Truck Mater, Mater becomes a monster truck wrestler and wrestles multiple different types of monster trucks, each with all kinds of different powers and strength. Well, as you can see, Mater was able to beat pretty much all of them, like Dr. Feelbad, for example. Mater was so strong that he once used his tow cable to launch Dr. Feelbad feet into the air all the way to the hospital. So yeah, he also has the strength to pretty much pour this guy's pretty much cement onto him using his tow cable once again. And his most impressive strength feat by far is when he was battling the monster truck guy thing. I still don't know, I guess he's some Frankenstein car or something, but even then, he was strong enough to lift the entire stadium, including him, and lift it upside down. Now, the average boxing ring in real life is said to weigh around 3,970 pounds, or 1,800 kilograms, which means that Mater most likely, it was probably just a regular boxing ring, just like any other monster truck ring, which means that Mater could possibly lift around that amount of strength. Now, this isn't exactly known for being in here for the section part. We're going to be going to the durability part next. But in the Mater Tall Tale short, Unidentified Flying Mater, Mater ends up meeting an alien called, which he calls Mator. Or Mator, I guess you say. Yeah, but Mator is an alien, in fact. Alien species do, in fact, exist in the Cars universe. And as we can see here, Mater is pretty much able to speak and talk with aliens, and even make friends with them as well, and even teach them his humble beginnings, like tractor tipping, for example. And this means that Mator is obviously more powerful than him. But yeah, now it's time we talk about the durability part, but And even then, we have, look at here, Mater is able to fly now thanks to Matador's electrical abilities, you could say. But yeah, we're moving on to durability now. Just wanted to mention that. As for Mater's durability, in the same short, Mater is able to survive falling from multiple different rocks and being crushed from them. Not crushed, but he does fall on impact on the rocks. But even then, he still manages to survive completely unscathed. Now, if this happened to a regular car or a regular tow truck, they would have immediately have been destroyed and possibly out of commission. But Mater, on the other hand, is able to survive this. So yeah, I guess this puts his durability at the very least, maybe small building level, just like Lightning, but possibly even smaller than Lightning. As I said, did Lightning was a large building level, but Mater is still highly durable. And this is the last durability he is going to be showcasing before I enter the final section, which is his different multiple personas or forms or whatever you call them. But in this right here, Mater is able to survive an attack from a bulldozer. And the bulldozer was strong enough to put him on the inside the ground and presume that Mater was dead. But he was still alive and lived. He had the durability to survive that. And this was a bulldozer. And not to say that the bulldozers in the Cars universe, though. I mean, yeah, they are the bulldozers, like a pun. But no, a real bulldozer would probably destroy a car out of commission that way. That's how strong a bulldozer is. But in the end, Mater was proven to be alive. Now it's time we talk about Mater's multiple different careers that he's taken on throughout his life. We have Mater the Greater. In Astronaut Mater, where Mater works as an astronaut to save a car from the moon. Heavy Metal Mater, where Mater works as a professional rock star. And finally, we have Rescue Squad Mater. Mater works as a fire truck to stop fires from burning down buildings and possibly killing people. And overall, we've reached the end of this video. Tow Mater is an extremely powerful character. Well, not the most powerful in fiction, but still, you would need a lot to rival him. He has the durability to survive mountain-level free falls, like crashing and impact on rocks, had multiple different careers in his belt, and means he has way more experience than a lot of other cars in this franchise, and can use his speed, his weapons, and his durability to his advantage. And can use an attack bonus, like his sun abilities or something, yeah. So yeah, overall, Mater is quite a powerful tow truck. It should never be underestimated. See you later.